Hello and welcome you all back. Today's topic is soldering. The solderings we have already using in our day-to-day life indirectly, because most of the electric components are jointed by using soldering. So that this topic is coming under welding and joining, and most probably if you're seeing these topics will be the last one. Not only mechanical, electrical, electronics, and most of these circuit and non-circuit branches are using this soldering. Without soldering, it is very difficult to produce an electrical electronics components. So before getting into the session, I just want to ask one question. Do you want to know why China's products are less cost? Any idea? Then what is the correlation between soldering and this topic? I have placed so many electrical electronics items. So you want to know the answer? Please don't skip the video. Watch it fully. Side by side, you will understand the concept, how they are making profit. So this is the simple schematic diagram for soldering process. Most probably in the first year, electrical and electronics laboratory, first year or second year, if you have, you may have the experience how to make the circuits. Anyway, I am telling once again, making soldering, we need three important components. One is soldering ion, second one is solder, and third one is the component, and fourth one is the circuit board. Component may be lead as shown in the figure, or transistor, resistor, capacitor, or IC chips, anything. Now, so what about the solders? What is the difference between soldering and brazing? I told you, brazing, the operation temperature is above 450 degrees Celsius. Here it is below to 450 degrees Celsius. This is the only thing. Second, we can use to join gold, silver, copper as shown in the sentence. You can use and the previous slide I have clearly told we need filler, solder, right? And how we are using? First we have to block the soldering ion, so it will absorb the electric energy, then it will convert the electrical energy into heat energy. Once it was gained the heat, just we have to touch the tip by using the solder as shown in the figure. There is a soldering rod was there, the first circuit, and we are using one filler metal over there. When it touching the sharp probe, it will melt and the molten metal will go and fill the gap. When it is solidified, the gap will be filled and it will be in joint. And next question I want to ask, whether is permanent joint or semi-permanent joint, right? Answer is, it's a semi-permanent joint. Whenever you don't want, or if you have made the circuit wrongly, you can easily take the object away from the PCB board. That also I'll tell in the last slide how we are going to do, right? So the second figure, you can see there is a schematic diagram how to join a resistor in a PCB board. It's a soldering ion. In the sharp end only we going to touch the solder, so it will melt and it will fill the gap, then it will make the joint. And what about the joint strength? This is the less strength joint ever seen in compared to other welding or brazing. This is a very less strength, because filler metal which we are using is tin and lead, so its joints will be less strength. And for my students, this is your assignment question. Please go through the topic and study, and it will be interesting. For your guidance, I just given one small figure and topic and web source. Please go to that web source. Please study the topic. It is very nice. So as a basic component, soldering wire, then paste and soldering ion, right? Type of solder, depending upon the DIN and lead proportion only, we are going to categorize. So it is very easy, 60, 40, 50, 50, 60, 37. The first 60 is indicating the DIN percentage, remaining is lead percentage. Depending upon the application and the temperature, you can choose this one. If you are using lead, it will damage the environment. So most probably we are go for lead free solder. However, practically we are not moved to that one because it's very difficult. So most probably we are using 50 to 50 solder, I think. This is in practical applications, how we are using the PCB board after joining the components. We are checking here, they're making check. And once your work is over, you can put the solder in the soldering hanger or holder, because the corner will be in hot, you cannot touch. So for safety aspect, you should put it over there. And these are the circuits how we are doing the soldering. Now there's a question I asked, how the Chinese products are less cost. I'm telling, so whatever the product, assume that your cell phone or some amplifier, let us take one, a small amplifier which is worked in your home, it was repaired, okay, so you have no idea to use that one, so you put it in the garbage. Chinese market will take that circuit, they will place the circuit on the electric pan in such a way that heat will melt the tin or lead mixture which is used to make the joint. Okay, after that they simply take the component, they will reuse, they will check what is the component, how many components are available, which one is failed, they will check. After carefully removing that one, they will use the remaining circuit board, they will replace the defected one with operating one, and simply they will give it us back. This is the simple secret how they are reusing the circuits, and this is the reason why their components are less cost. You see, if you are working with soldering, the lead is a dangerous one. It will melt, it will mix with the air, and it will go and fill your lungs if you are breathing that air. The person, those who are working with this thing, will be easily affected by lung cancer or breathing problem. Not only this, all the welding process will cost, but here it is severe. They will wear some personal protective equipment. However, we can't stop this thing. Thanks for watching. Thank you.